Hi, good morning students. Welcome back to your English lecture with your teacher Veena Iyer here. So today we are going to learn something more important or value that we'll be getting from this lesson once we complete it. So I would request you all to understand this lesson in such a brief manner where you all will also try to come up with such good habits and some values that are being brought up in this lesson throughout your life, as it is in the life of Anshuman in this story. So let's move with the lesson number 18, Weeds in the Garden. Let's begin with the lesson. Most of the parents like to fulfill the wishes of their children. They feel sorry when they cannot indulge their kids or when they have to scold them. And when even a scolding has no effect, the parents become very, very unhappy. Such was the case with Anshuman and his parents. Now, as you all as well are the same, you know, when your parents find out that you have done something wrong in school or, you know, in your outskirts of building, and people come and complain about you to your parents, first they try to make you understand the child, don't do this, these are bad habits, these are good habits, you should never do it. But what happens? We often tend to like, no mom, leave it, she's shouting, she always does, why should I? But children, those are the first warnings that we are going to learn in our life. We should always understand that small, small bad habits will also lead into big trouble in our life. We should learn from the bad habits and improve into good habits, you know. So when they scold you, understand it and try to improve it in a right manner. And don't make them to beat you so that it will become such a thing that you will try to, you know, feel as if your parents don't care for you and all. But all these things are their love towards you. They want to see you in a good way or in a right path of your life. Such was the case with our boy Anshuman in the story, where people often try to make him understand by, you know, warnings or some good things that he should not do anything wrong, or but he never understands it. And his parents were in a great trouble that how to make their child understand that he is doing a wrong thing. He is troubling others or he is mischievous. So here, meaning of indulge, let someone have or do what they want, even if it is not good for them, to satisfy wishes. Like your parents also try to satisfy your wishes. If it is your birthday, without asking you, they give you surprises. They have a celebration at home. They call out your friends and many more things. They present you a gift. So they are trying to satisfy your wishes. Then why can't you understand them and satisfy their wishes? Now, second one, has no effect as a phrase. The meaning of it is useless. Now, Anshuman's parents had noticed that he was developing some bad habits. Now, our boy is developing some bad habits in him. Naturally, they began to warn him time and again, but all in vain. They were trying to make him understand that we should not do such things. There are some bad habits that you're coming up with. This is not good when you're living in a good society or a good family. But it was of no use. In a vain means without any success or no use or useless. Anshuman just wouldn't listen. He refused to believe that he was letting those bad habits get a hold over him. That means he thought, let mom and dad shout, what happens? I will do what I want. And due to this kind of habit, what happened? He was not letting those words of their parents under control of him. Instead, those bad habits got control in him. Gentle words, strict warnings, scolding. Now and then, his parents tried everything short of beating him up. Everything was done by his parents for him to make him a good boy. But they would never work out on him. However, unhappy they themselves were, they wanted to be loving and gentle as they tried to correct their son's ways. Short of beating him up means without going so far as to beat him up. So, let anything they do, but they were unhappy to the core that their son was not at all improving. He is as it is as he was in all his bad habits. But they always tried that it should not happen. They wanted to be loving and gentle towards their son. but due to his bad deeds, they would often end up in shouting or scolding him. Soon an opportunity presented itself. Anshuman had gone to stay on his grandfather's farm with his parents. Early one morning, his father took him for a walk around the farm. He was describing the specialities of various plants and vines and bushes and trees to Anshuman. Now what happened? One soft day, it was like all of them went to their grandfather's farm away from their house. And it was like something from God's grace. There was a chance where Anshuman can be changed, was felt by his father. Opportunity, a chance. Now, and they were with their grandfather. He and his father went to Anshuman's grandfather's farm. Now, one morning, he and his father were walking in the farm. When they were for a walk, Anshuman was describing all the specialities, that is special qualities. That means whatever he was watching new or different or something good. He was describing all those things that he found, like plants, vines. Now what are vines? Vines are a kind of climbing plants, bushes and trees that were found in the farm. Now his father was speaking about all these things to Anshuman. Now what happened? Suddenly he stopped and pointed at a small seedling growing near a plant. Now Anshuman, when he was walking, he stopped somewhere and he took up pointing out to a small seedling that was growing near a good plant. Anshuman, that's weed. Can you pull it out? Now this was spoken to him by his father. What did his father say? Anshuman, you know that small seedling is nothing but a weed. Can you pull it out? Anshuman had no difficulty in pulling all of the small seedling out. He was taking up small weeds. Now his father said, good. And they continued again with their walk. Now what is a weed? A weed is a wild plant growing where it is not wanted. Now you all might have seen, if you have garden in your house, small plants that you grow up in your house, you may find that near that plants there are small unwanted plants growing up, which may harm our original fruit or flowering plants. Now these small unwanted plants are called as weeds. Now what happened? After a while, they came upon the same weed, but there it had grown slightly bigger. They saw a big weed now. And it was as if it will spoil the plant. Anshuman's father told him to pull out this plant too. Now, as he pulled out small weeds, now Anshuman's father said to Anshuman that pull out this big weed too. He told him to uproot the weed carefully, making sure that no trace, not a very small amount of weed or its root should be seen in that area now. In such a way, you have to pluck it out of the root was left in the soil. Otherwise, the weed can grow again, was the warning given to Anshuman by his father. Anshuman uprooted the plant carefully, twisting it like turning it and all, pulling it hard so that the whole of it came out. He was trying his level best to take up that weed outside. Then his father drew his attention to the same weed growing at some distance. There, it had grown into a big plant with tiny flowers and dark fruit. That could be quite dangerous. We mustn't leave it growing here. Now his father was saying, see, you did everything that's possible. Now we have one more weed in this farm that may affect all the crops that are growing here. Can you pluck it out as fast as possible as you did like for these? But remember, it could be quite dangerous if it is growing in near that our good flowering and like fruiting plants. You have to take it up because now it is into a big plant with its own flowers and fruits. So we should not allow it to grow with our good plants. Take it out, said Anshuman's father. Anshuman held the plant in his hands. Anshuman, as usual, held the plant at the top in his hands and gave it a tug. Give it a tug means gave it a pull. He started pulling it out. The weed didn't move at all. The weed was not at all coming out. Only he was applying his entire strength in pulling it. He pulled harder and harder. He had given up all his strength, but to no avail. Again, to no avail means with no success. "I can't get this out," exclaimed Anshuman. Anshuman said, "Father, I can't take up this weed outside. What should I do now? It has gone too deep into the soil. It's very hard to pluck it up. Help me out." So, then his father brought some implements. Now, what did his father do? His father thought that he should help his son in taking up this big plant grown like weed. You know? So they dug around the weed with a great effort and pulled it out. When they were returning home after the hard work, Anshuman's father mentioned him. Like after plucking up that weed also, Anshuman's father started speaking to his son about what all they experienced now in the farm. He said, "Habits are like weeds. The longer you grow them to allow them to grow, the harder it is to uproot them. It is wise to get rid of them when it is easy to do so." Now, what did Anshuman's father say to Anshuman? Anshuman's father said, "Child, you know, like these weeds, even habits are so tough. Once you allow bad habits to grow in you, inner you, what happens is it is very hard to remove them. You know, often we end up in our childhood doing some bad things and good things. But we often are habituated to get into more negativities, but we never know that these negativities would lead us into trouble. Similarly, these weeds are. You saw just now, he was trying to pluck up small weeds, but the weed that had grown into a big plant with fruits and flowers in it, it was so difficult for him to take it up. Now just think, if you are also heading into some bad habits and you're not trying to move out of it, and when you're grown up, you know, when you're growing into youth and still this bad habit is there in you and it is also moving up and up and up with some more bad things in it, do you think it is that easy to take that bad habits from you and turn into a good one? No, it's very, very difficult, because at that time it is high time that you won't realize that these bad habits have taken up yourself into a bad character, that people may tend to ignore you or avoid you into their companionship or group. So always remember, children, never keep bad habits in you till long. If you realize that you're doing a wrong thing, that you're saying a lie or you're stolen something, please speak up the truth that yes, sorry that I have said a lie. Say your friend or parents, "Sorry that I have, you know, stolen my friend's pen or pencil. But this is the last time. Next time onwards, I will ask the person and then I will take. I won't ever, you know, steal books or pen or pencil or say a lie or beat up somebody or say some bad words or bad things, because these are not in your culture. Our culture speaks to help others, to say truth, to be kind, to be pleasant towards everyone that is around us. If we do good, we will get in return good. You know, God is great. He will help you all to live a life of peace and happiness if you are in your right path." Okay, so hence the same thing, Anshuman also realized the truth in his father's words. Throughout his life, he never forgot that early morning walk on the farm with his father. Now, implements, tools or instruments. To get rid of means to take action so as to be free of something. Now, as here, our child Anshuman, once he grew up into a young man, he also understood those days when he was bad, and that one day in the farm made him realize his bad things and turn him into a good one, where he is today with a good character and others are happy with him. Now, children, we have ended up with our lesson over here, Weeds in the Garden, with a hidden value about good habits and bad habits. I guess you all will also understand this chapter and try to come up with good habits rather than getting into bad ones. Thank you once again for watching this video, children.